Let's get started in a nice and comfortable seated position. This is how I start my own personal practice. And I do like to take my knees out to the left and to the right and kind of snuggle my feet in a little bit closer. Tip the chin directly down into the chest first and foremost and start to take it side to side. I want you to start deepening into your inhales and your exhales now. Concentrate on the areas that are feeling a little bit tight for you and hang out there for a second if you need to. And simultaneously, feel free to tilt your chin directly up into the ceiling. But if you're doing that, you have to consider bringing your chin forward at a 45 degree angle. And what helps too is if you imagine your bottom jaw like a drawer that you're pulling out, jut your bottom jaw forward by that 45 degree angle, and you should feel a nice stretch through the front of your neck. Simultaneously, some of you guys might even take two fingers and find your sternum right in the center of your chest and just start to massage it up and down, left, right, clockwise and counterclockwise, and like up and down, you might even go pretty low down into the very center of your chest. There's a lot of tightness that does form in the front of the chest, and it's important that we work out the tissues as best as possible. Now eventually, we'll go ahead and sweep the hands directly up into the ceiling, and as you do that, we take a nice deep inhale, exhale, interlock your fingers, but behind your back. Shrug the shoulders up and down, and carry your hands over to your left-hand side. Once the hands are over to the left-hand side, I'm actually hooking the back of my hand onto my rib cage, bringing this left shoulder up, and then squeezing it back behind me, tipping your head over to the left-hand side. Shoulder blades are sliding down the back body. Don't forget to slide the glutes down to the ground as well. And as you continue to squeeze that left shoulder back and also down, the elbow begins to wing back as well, feeling a nice stretch, hopefully through the front of the chest. Feel free now to turn your chin down to your left armpit, even down into your left collarbones. Bring the head back up. Inhale, sweep the hands back up into the ceiling. And when you exhale, interlace your fingers the way that feels funny to you behind your back. Once again, shoulders up and back as you carry them over to the right hand side. Once there, notice this right elbow. Bring the right shoulder up, squeeze it back behind you, and then draw the shoulder blade down. Simultaneously, tipping your right ear over to your right shoulder now. Breathe deep, because the deeper that you breathe, it's almost as if you could stretch out those muscles like saltwater taffy a little bit more. Nuzzle the chin into your right armpit, down into the right collarbones if you'd like to. Saltwater taffy. Where can we buy those? Head comes back up. Inhale, sweep the hands up into the sky. And as you exhale, relax your hands down and climb forward onto all fours tabletop position. As always, customize this practice to what you need, nothing more, nothing less. Spread your hands out as wide as you can. And with the next inhale, drop the belly, arc the heart, and turn your gaze up into the skies. As you exhale, round, but also wrist push up. See if you can come up onto your fingertips. Inhale, drop the belly, drop the hands, arc the heart. And as you exhale, round, come up onto your fingertips, wrist push-ups, nuzzle the chin to your pubic bone. Inhale, belly drops, hands drop. Exhale, round it out. Now I want you guys to move just like this, but you guys could also take your rib cages to the left and to the right, and you can have your hands flat down onto the ground if you wish. If all of a sudden in all of this movement, you found something that you're like, oh dang, that's such a good stretch, I want you to hold it right there because you found the treasure trove. And then maybe that's an indication for you in the practice to concentrate on. Shortly, we're coming back in towards this neutral tabletop position. And once there, send the legs back behind you one at a time for plank position or high push-up. Set your feet out a little bit wider. At any moment, if you need to drop one knee down to the ground or even both of the knees down to the ground, do that for yourself because there's no sense in suffering the suffering. Remember those wrist push-ups, locate that right hand of yours, come up onto your right fingertips. Oh, I know. Now notice if you're tilting all the body weight over to the left, and see if you can even out your hips. Optional, reach your right hand forward towards me. If you need to, drop a knee, and if you don't, optional, lift your left foot. Deep inhale, big exhale. One more time, deep breath, Exhale, drop it. Inhale, belly drops, arc the heart, and turn your gaze up. Exhale, round, but press all the way back. Child's pose, rest onto your forearms. Keep the forearms down. Pull your heart forward to the front. Glide it towards your thumbs. And at the last possible moment, use the strength of your triceps to lift straight up, and then round all the way back. Here's the second one if you're not sure. I'm dragging my heart forward, forward, forward. Elbows are going to start lifting, and then I use my triceps to lift for the last bit. One more time. Inhale, forward we go. Straight lift with the triceps, round all the way back. Back into this neutral spine. Spread your hands out, send the legs back behind you one at a time. Set your feet out a little bit wider because if it's narrow, it's just gonna be harder for you to balance in the next bit. And at any moment, you can drop one knee down to the ground. Locate your left hand, come up onto the left fingertips. It's natural for your body to tip over to the right. And instead, we're trying our best to even the torso. Okay, give it a go. Reach your left hand forward. If that feels okay, oh, this one's tough for me, the right one. Shaking, deep inhale, big exhale. One more time. Everything down, this time push back, downward facing dog. Bend out your knees and sway out the hips. Already, I'm feeling quite warm from that, so I know that you guys are too. In your downward facing dog, look to the front, bend very deep into the knees, step walk or hop to the top. Half lift, big exhale, more weight into your forefoot and fold. Inhale, half lift again. Exhale so that you could fold. Very last time, deep breath in. Exhale, fold and hold. You can dangle your arms down. You can certainly hold on to opposite elbows, hug the legs, or even scoop up your toes. Shift more weight into your forefoot. Here we go. If you do have hold of your arms, let them slide down to the ground. Everybody put a very gentle bend into your knees, look forward, and rise. Bring your hands all the way up into the skies. Exhale, take it home, Anjali Mudra. It's a deep inhale. Exhale, hands onto your hips, take a very gentle bend in your knees. Shift weight into your right foot. Left ankle picks up and crosses like a figure four. Sit back into your imaginary chair. And as you do that, the crown of the head points forward and the booties, they go to the back. Soften your shoulders. Bring the lower two ribs in. Shift weight into your right heel. Okay, friends. This one's a little bit different. Take your hands onto your hips and bring your torso back up. Lift your left knee up along for the ride. Point the left toes, but then kind of like flank the foot. So you're kind of flexing into the toes so you have a little bit of a shelf. Wrap this leg back behind you. Reach down with your right hand and see if you can grab hold of that foot. If you need to, find a wall, find a chair. Otherwise, bring the lower two ribs in, squeeze your glutes a whole heck of a lot. You should start feeling this through the front of your quads. Try to bring the heel closer to your right glute, maybe even the left glute. Optional, bringing your other hand up into the sky for more balance. If your left hand is up in the sky, keep it there. Think about warrior one position, thread that foot to the back, and we drop warrior one. Lower two ribs still pulling in, drive your pelvis forward. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, come up onto your tippy toes and slice the hands behind you. Inhale, hands go back up, but you seal the heel. Good. Exhale, slice the hands behind, come up onto your tippy toes so we don't torque the knee. Inhaling, hands up, seal the heel. Exhale, slice behind. Now hold it right here. Shift more weight preemptively into your right heel. When you're ready, straighten your leg. And it's a straightening of this leg that actually lifts the back leg. Square the hip. Hip, knee, and toes down. Flex your foot. Hands can be behind you, hands on hips, or straight forward to the front. crisscross applesauce, hands down, slice your foot over to your right hand side, land your foot. Squeeze, this time your right hip back, left one forward. Put your hands on a block if you need to, and if you don't have it, be careful because they're wobbly. You can also use a water bottle. Play with this, shift your collarbones forward and backwards. When I am doing that, my back toes, or my heel rather, is lifting onto the off the ground, and I'm kind of pivoting on the toes. Keep squeezing, right hip back, left one forward. Okay. Pavrita Ardha Chandrasana, reverse half moon. Plant your hands down firm. It is helpful actually to have a block for your right hand. Go ahead and return your left leg back up. Hold, stack now. Your left hip on top of the right one, Ardha Chandrasana or half moon pose just to begin with. Get used to the shape. I don't want you guys to get too tired, so return your left hand down to the ground or put it underneath that block. And now twist to your right hand side. The back leg is gonna drop. See if you can keep it lifted as you continue to twist. Optional, lift your right hand. Reverse half moon pose. Reverse warrior two pose. Drop the back toes down. You're staying on your tiptoes and pull up. Reverse warrior two. Keep the legs like this. Inhale, sweep the hands up. Keep the legs like this, but open warrior two. Keep the back heel off the ground for now. And as you're twisting your body, you should feel a different stretch. Warrior two as you know it, seal the heel. Deep breath. Exhale, straighten the leg. Drop your hands down for a second. Bring your hands back up. Return warrior two position. Deep inhale. Exhale, straighten and drop. Hands up, back to warrior two position. Last one, you're on your own. If you make something up, hey man, just make it up. That's what yoga teachers are doing. We're just making stuff up all the time. Hold. Okay, friends. Flip your right palm, trickle backwards. If your leg gets tired, easy. Just straighten out the leg and come back in when you're ready. If you need to keep it straight the entire time in this practice, that's okay. Back hand, either bend into your elbow or even find a bind, holding onto your own hand, but behind your back like that. Drive your elbow up into the ceiling, keep leaning backwards, squeeze the glutes, protect your spine. And finally, return back, warrior two position, just for a second. Hands to heart center, pray for something. Straighten your front leg, bend your back leg. Stay high or get low. If you need to, get your hands on the floor so that you have a little bit more balance. One hand to heart, maybe even two. Okay, friends. This left knee of yours, put it straight onto the floor. Untuck your left toe, sit back upon your left heel, and now slide your hands forward away from you, feeling a nice stretch through the right inner thigh. Optional, dropping down onto an elbow or bringing something to lift the floor closer to you. Okay. Try not to overthink it. Have a seat behind your left heel. Good. That right leg is straight in front of you. Lengthen and exhale, fold to the right leg. Optional, using your left hand to hold onto the outside edge of the foot or even the side of your shin. My right hand is here, and I'm going to imagine that I'm actually sinking it down into the ground and I'm pushing it forward to the front. In that push forward, what it does, it sets my right shoulder back to allow chin, heart, and belly button to center down this thigh a little better. Okay. Lift your torso. Pick up your right foot and cross it over. Scoot forward to the front as you come into this figure four. Shin torso closer together. And if you need to, maybe it doesn't go that close. Maybe it goes a little bit further out. Not everyone's going to get to that next step in one fell swoop, myself included. I don't know yet. So if you can't quite get there, just meet us in the next pose. We're coming back into the bookend, back from where we started. See if you could now come back into that figure four. So I'm going to use my hands, lift my bum, and then come back up this way. Once there, we're still enjoying this nice hip opening, dragging the left hip back, right one forward, keeping this foot flexed to protect my kneecap. I know it sounds crazy. Imagine your ankle was actually glued to your thigh. It's not going to change. It's not going to lift. Here's what I want you guys to try to do. We are jumping back into a half plank. That means you have to jump back with bent elbows. If you can't do it in one jump, do several. If you're doing several, it's gonna look like this. Right ankle stays there, only the left foot starts to hop back, just like that. We keep the foot there. If you got it in that one go, we land half plank. Keep the leg like this, come all the way down to the ground. So my foot is still on my thigh and we're breathing steady. You can be high, you can also be low. And if you're going high, some of you guys might come into a Sphinx, forearms down onto the ground, squeeze the glutes a lot. You should not hurt your back at all. So if this pinches your low back, you've gone too far, back out. Okay. Keep the left ankle glued to your thigh. Try to push up into a plank position. What? All right, so my hands are gonna plant down pretty firm. They're right by my nipples. Tuck your right toes under, keep the left ankle glued there, and lift up in one piece, and then step back, downward facing dog. Bend out your knees, sway out your hips. Drop down, child's pose. Hands can be forward, hands can be behind you, forehead can be up, forehead could be down, maybe just the forearms down. Choose what works the best. Okay, grab as much liquid as you might need. If anyone has a corgi and you need a babysitting service, please let me know, because this is as close as I've come to having a corgi. Okay, let's strengthen up the upper body. Then your upper body is going to get quite tired. Then we'll switch it back into the second side of the sequencing. All right, hands are going to interlace, but they're not going to be clasped super tight. Almost imagine that I placed a tomato right in between your hands and you wanted to keep that tomato exactly where it is. At any point, you can drop down onto the knees and still continue to do what I'm going to ask you to do. Those of you who feel comfortable, let's get into the crocodile pose. Tuck your toes under, sorry, not crocodile, dolphin, and lift your hips. Shoulders will like to go to the bottom of your earlobes. Create space. If anything, you can stay right here. Watch that tomato between your hands. Inhale, pull the chin forward towards your thumbs. Exhale, push back. Forward to the thumbs, even past the thumbs, maybe past the fingers. Push back. Keep going, inhaling forward, pushing back. Watch that tomato. We don't want some gazpacho on your mat. No way. It'll be a mess. It'll take forever to clean up. Last time, hold it here. Optional, walk your feet back and arrive to a military press. Careful of your hands. Make sure that they're not gripping for dear life. Push the heels into this imaginary wall. Squeeze your glutes like crazy. Bring the lower two ribs in. Deep core activation. So what are you guys going to do later today? Just hang out? That's cool. Drop down onto your knees. Slide back, child's pose. Hot dog. Okay, I do need to get you guys all back in a forward fold, but here's where we can play a little bit. Break your mat up into thirds, one third, two thirds, three thirds. Every time that you jump, try to get the heels to touch your bum and find hang time. What? Okay, let me pull up my super high-waisted pants. Here we go. Here's what it's gonna look like. You go to a downward facing dog and you break your mat up into thirds. Heels touch the bum because it's easier to balance as a tiny little ball instead of limbs flailing everywhere. Okay, so you look forward, bend to the knees, jump up one third of the way. Heels touch your bum. All right, jump up two thirds of the way. Heels touch your bum. And then three thirds of the way. This is the hardest one. Woo-hoo! Half lift. Exhale, fold. I was scared I was gonna bail on IG Live. Inhaling, half lift. Exhale, fold again. Last time, and then fold and hold, my friends. Arms can dangle, opposite elbows, hug the legs, or scoop up the toes, but definitely let your head go. Soften your legs and start to rise. Bring your hands all the way to the skies. Straight away, hands onto your hips. Bend into your knees, shift weight this time into your left leg. Right ankle picks up and crosses. Flex your foot to protect the knee. Sit back into an imaginary chair. Grab a wall, grab a chair if you need to. Keep sinking down. If you were to imagine, I came and I grabbed the front of your right hip and I dragged it to the back. That should deepen your stretch. Left toes, not gripping for dear life. They can't really help you anyways. Shift more weight into your heel. Okay. One hand to the hip, followed by the second, rise to stand. Bring your right knee up along for the ride. Point the toes down first, and then point it like a Barbie foot, and thread it to the back. Reach down with your left hand. You might need to contract your body to do it, and then try to stand tall. Same thing, find a wall if you need to, find a chair if you need to. Squeeze your right quad. Bring your heel as close to your left glute as possible. Some of you guys might be in the middle of the body. Some of you might even be able to bring it to your right bum cheek. Your right hand might lift to the sky for balance. But if you're using it to hold on for balance, that's fine. If your right hand is up there, keep it up there. Think about warrior one position. Thread this foot to the back and land it. Bring your hands up, warrior one. In a warrior one position, tilt your pelvis forward to the front so that you feel this through the front of the leg. Okay, deep breath in. Lean forward, rock up onto your right tippy toes. Inhaling, hands up, seal the heel. Slice forward, rock up onto your tippy toes. One last time, inhaling. Exhale, slice behind you, hold it steady. Shift more weight preemptively into your left heel. It is a straightening of your left leg that actually drags the right toes up. Hinge at the hips by a little or a whole lot. Hip, knee, and toes pointing down as you continue to fold. Hands forward, hands behind, hands on hips, you choose. I am feeling it in my left glute for sure. Ooh. Hands down, touch the ground. I do like to grab a block from my hand, put it underneath your left hand. First and foremost, half moon pose. Stack the right hip on top just so that you can release out some things. You might have heard my hip crack there. Reverse half moon, right hand returns back down to the ground. I'm gonna swap my block over. Take my hand to the base of my spine. As I twist, the right leg wants to drop. So instead, I have to fight it and bring it up. Left hand might go up into the sky. Reverse half moon, bend generously into that left knee of yours, land your back toes, and pull up this reverse position. Squeeze your pelvis forward. Keep the legs like this. Bring your hands up. Keep the legs like this and open in a warrior two variation. We're still up onto your tippy toes. Drive your pelvis forward. You should feel it a little differently. Seal the heel. Deep breath. Exhale, straighten and drop. Hands up into the sky. Back to a warrior two position. Continue to bring the lower two ribs into your body. Deep breath. Straighten and drop. Hands up. Back to warrior two. Very last time. Make it up if you don't remember. Hold it steady. I know your leg is tired, so straighten out the leg. Flip your left palm. Trickle backwards. Watch out for hyperextension. You'll know it locks into place. Bring yourself right before the locking mechanisms. Back hand, either hand on hip, turning yourself into a little teapot, or binding your pose, hands holding on behind your back. If you're not quite there, grab hold of your shirt. If you're not wearing a shirt, wear a shirt next time. Just kidding. Drive your elbow up into the sky. Keep tipping backwards. Come back to a warrior two position. Deep inhale, hands to heart, straighten out your front leg, bend into the back one. Some of you guys might be able to balance all the way down. And for some, you might actually need your hands on the floor to support you. Feeling a nice good stretch through the inner thigh. Let's continue stretching the inner thigh. So this right knee of yours, put it on the ground. Untuck your right toe, sit back upon your heel. Start to slide your hands away from you. You may or may not be able to get down onto your elbow. You may or may not be so close to your drink, you can have some. Try not to get too discombobulated. Just sit behind your right heel. Bring your torso up. Have a seat behind your right heel. Yours is gonna look a little bit more like this. Lengthen, turn yourself down the length of this leg and fold. Anyone can go further if you use your right hand to hold onto the outside edge of the leg or the foot. My left hand is going to stay here, but I'm actively pressing my fingers forward. Even though they don't go anywhere, that action of pressing it forward draws my shoulder back to allow chin, heart, belly button down the center of this leg. All right, torso lifts. Right ankle on top of your left thigh. Scoot forward to the front, bend your left knee as you do it. Take it at your own pace. If you need a little bit less of a bend, do less of a bend. This is really good for opening up those muscles that are just kind of tight, a little bit stuck, when you are sitting or standing for long periods of time. This next step, you might not get there in like one smooth, fluid movement. Sometimes I don't either. So do what you need to do. We'll plant the foot down firm, lift the glutes, and then use the hands to rock forward. Enter into your hip opening. This right hip bone drags back behind you. These toes are flexed to protect and to support you. Baby hops are perfect, and just do the baby hop if you want to. Several steps with your left foot all the way back into that half plank position. Those of you guys who are doing this in one go, you have to land with bent elbows to protect the shoulder girdle. So we plant the hands down. Remember, this right ankle is glued here. Step back, baby hops like this, or the one full step. Keep the foot flexed, keep driving your knee up into the ceiling, and go all the way down to the ground. When you do that, that foot is still actually on the thigh, and I'm kind of using it almost like a foam roller for my left quad. You can stay high, it's a little bit more of a back bend, or you can get a lot lower. Those of you who are staying high, rest your forearms onto the floor and come into a sphinx-like position. Wherever you're at, anybody, squeeze your glutes to protect your back. Do you know what the banana said when he went into the change room? He said, "Well, I find this very appealing." Appealing. It's funny. It's funny. Firm the muscles. Keep your right ankle glued to your left thigh. Hands underneath, tuck your left toes under, engage to lift. Everything is in one piece, and we push up. Everybody, downward facing dog. Bend out your knees, sway out your hips. Bring your thumbs together to touch. Try to hop your feet beside your pinky fingers. All right. Grab water if you need to, hands fold to heart center. You can sway to the left and to the right. Some of you guys, when you're here, you actually don't feel anything anymore. If that is you, rest your elbows on top of your thighs. I'll turn to the side so you see it better. And as I lean my torso forward at a 45 degree angle, I'll push that to the back. Then it's almost like we're trying to go into the Russian splits instead. Okay, we're just gonna try things on for size, of course. Next step, Titibhasana. Walk one shoulder underneath your knee, followed by the second. What? You'll notice that when I come into the pose, my hands are actually tented. And when I sit onto my own triceps, that's when my hands go flat down onto the ground. Okay, watch. We bring one hand underneath the ankle, and I'll use it as leverage to walk one shoulder under. Then I'll walk the other shoulder under. At this point, I'm coming up onto fingertips and I'm leaning backwards. Once I lean all the way back, the hands are going to plant. Optional one foot, maybe two. And then we try to straighten out the legs for a pose known as Titibhasana. Have a seat. All right, soles of the feet together. Knees out left and right. Lengthen, fold. Titibhasana, when I first started that pose, it was like walking one shoulder underneath, walking the other, and then like boom, bum down onto the ground immediately. With time and with practice, it will get easier. Just keep practicing. You'll find maybe a half second more of balance before the bum hits. And eventually that'll be turned into 2 more seconds, 4 more seconds, 5 more seconds, and then you'll be able to hold it for a lot longer than you originally thought.
Now, I don't even know if the girl who requested it is even in this class, but we are about to go into something called the octopus. It is the most challenging abdominal workout that you're ever going to do, and I encourage you to do it at every single gym in front of lots of people. Okay, ready? Lift your torso, scoop the knees in, and give yourself a big old hug. Nuzzle the chin in. Think of an octopus in the sea. The limbs are like everywhere. Oh, she is in this class. Amazing. Okay. The limbs are everywhere and you have to like ebb and flow in the water. Don't worry about what this looks like because I am the one who's actually being filmed. So you just do you in your own home. All right, you guys ready? We scoop up the undersides of the knees just so that we can begin. If you have low back pain, just be careful or pat out your tailbone at this moment. When you are ready, here we go. We're going into the octopus. That means your arms are flailing everywhere and the limbs are flailing everywhere and you're going down a little bit lower, a little bit lower, a little bit lower, and then like an octopus, you come all the way back up and then you just keep going down, 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 up, up, up. Left and right. Make sure you get the obliques. You gotta go left and right. Limbs everywhere. Whew. This would have been better in a Zoom class where I could see everyone else. Get lower and lower and lower. Ebb and flow. Ebb and flow. Ebb and flow. Ebb and flow. And down. Okay. Once you are down onto the ground, give your knees a big hug. I don't know what this is called. It's like the Jay-Z triangle. Okay, get your Jay-Z triangles. Is it the Illuminati triangle? I don't know. Anyways, get your triangle and bring it up into the ceiling. Try not to move the triangle at all. So that's there. It's framing whatever part of the ceiling or the sky that you are looking at. The knees are bent. Take a deep inhale. Imprint your spine. That means you're pressing your low back into the ground entirely. You're sealing everything off. Keep that frame in the triangle. Nothing's going to change. Take a deep inhale. Chin in. Exhale. Lift straight up. Try not to change what is framed in the triangle. Come back down. Come all the way back up and then back down. It's hard not to move the triangle because typically we do want to use the arms to propel us forward in momentum. And at this moment, we're taking all of that out and we're just holding. Once you're up there, hold it like this. Keep holding it like this. Hands down by the side. Now we're going into wiggle worm. Wiggle worm, tap your left heel, tap the right heel, and then just going side to side. If the back of your neck is starting to bother you, nuzzle the chin into the chest or take a break. Take a break, man. Wiggle worm. If you're on the floor without a mat like I am, you are polishing this one area on your floor. Last five, four, three, two, and one. Relax. The feet are still set approximately hip-width distance apart. You should be able to graze the heels with the tips of your fingers. The middle finger is your longest one. If you know that you have short arms, you're not going to be able to touch that, and that is fine. Lower two ribs are in, squeeze the glutes, and lift your hips. If you are lucky enough at home to have something to put at your sacrum, that big flat triangular bone, you can put that there instead. Otherwise, we are lifted, engaging into the glutes. Those of you guys who want extra glute work, flex your toes and rock up onto your heels so that the toes are actually pointed up and you're driving your pelvis upwards. As if I place a gift card right in between your booty to your favorite local pizza shop. Those of you guys in Calgary, that local pizza shop might be Home and Away. It might be Una Pizza or your other local shop. Those are my tops.
lower down. Okay. Walk your feet out a little bit wider. TP the knees inwards. They may or may not touch. If they don't touch, that's okay. Deep breaths in. Big sighs out. If you want to play with breath work, place one hand on top of your chest and one hand at the belly. When you inhale, belly rises first, and then your chest. And as you exhale, the chest deflates first, and then the belly. Inhale, belly first. Hand on chest rises. Exhale, hand on chest begins to push down first, and then the belly. One last time. All right. We're entering a moment in practice where if you're ready for final Shavasana, extend your legs forward, let your limbs open out left and right. Those of you guys who have poses that you still really wish that we would have done and I didn't have an opportunity to do for you, please do those things now. And as you lay on your back, either finishing up what you need to, or in Shavasana, allow yourself an opportunity to just sink in. The Yoga Sutras is one of the oldest texts in yogic history, one of the most translated. And the very first line of the Yoga Sutras says, Atta Yoga Nushasanam. Translated, that means here, now, is the practice of yoga. It is in reference not to the physical practice that you do on your mat. Here now is the practice of yoga, is when you have to navigate, move, and operate through this world. That's when your yoga is going to be tested. The real practice lies beyond the four walls of a yoga studio, lies beyond the four walls of your home, and definitely beyond the four corners of your yoga mat. Whenever we get into spicy situations, spicy interactions, it is always helpful for me to remember that this person is doing the best that they can with the tools that they have. They might not be the same tools as mine. They might not agree with my tools either, and I might not agree with theirs, but they're doing the best. I'm doing my best. And in that, here now is the practice of yoga. Breathe and let go. Thank you. inhales and great big exhales. Head rolls to the left and to the right. An opportunity for you to collect yourself again. Collect the tools that you have in your arsenal. And as you continue to breathe like this, head rolls left and right, wiggle fingers, wiggle toes, turn wrists, point and flex your feet, and then because it feels good, take a nice deep stretch. Knees bend, feet will hit the ground. You have a choice. Off to the right-hand side for relaxation, over to the left if it's actually energy that you are searching for. Whatever you've got is perfect. Hands fold into heart center, bow the chin into yourself. Be proud of the way that you are moving through this world with the tools that you have. Be proud of the tools that you are cultivating and fostering in your yoga practice and in day-to-day existence. It is always from the deepest place in my heart, the deepest place in yours, that I bow humbly and in your service. Namaste.